Hi everyone, I'm Any New Province, and this week we're going to find out if Cavalry Drillmaster is possibly Pauper playable. Cavalry Drillmaster is a brand new creature from Core Set 2019. It costs 1 and a white for a 2/1, and when it enters the battlefield, target creature gets +2/+0 and gains first strike until end of turn. Cavalry Drillmaster and this deck have already earned themselves a 5-0 victory in a Magic the Gathering online league in the hands of deck builder Nichols. Of course, it's always exciting when brand new cards break through and make an impact on the Pauper metagame. I'm really looking forward to seeing how Nichols did that with Cavalry Drillmaster and their deck Mono White Aggro. We're trying to win the game by flooding the board with a ton of white creatures, so of course this deck runs lots of them. First, I'll go over the white creatures that have a little bit more utility than just attacking. I'll start with Icacian Javelineers. It costs 1 white mana for a 1/1, and it enters the battlefield with a javelin counter on it. You can tap it, remove a javelin counter from it to deal 1 damage to any target. In a format where Spellstutter Sprite is so popular, it's always useful to have a pinger to shoot them out of the sky when they're trying to counter your spells. Besides that, Icacian Javelineers can help your creatures trade up by doing the last point of damage for them. Also, this deck has ways to recur the Javelineers so that hopefully over the course of the game it gets to remove more than one creature. Next is Thraben Inspector, which costs 1 white for a 1/2, and when it enters the battlefield, you get a clue token. A clue token is something that you can pay 2, tap, and sacrifice to draw a card. Low to the ground creature decks like this lack consistency. You have to just hope you draw into the right cards at the right time. Thraben Inspector helps a bit by giving you clues to generate a tiny bit of card advantage and hopefully smooth out any of those inconsistent draws. Finally, we have Deathblade Elite, which costs 1 white mana for a 1/1 with Provoke, a super cool ability. What it means is, whenever this creature attacks, you may have target creature defending player controls untap and block it if able. The Provoke ability is so useful. We're going to force our opponents to block our Deathblade Elites with creatures that they might need for other purposes and wouldn't have blocked the Deathblade with otherwise. Deathblade Elite's second ability turns it into more of a falter effect when you're trying to force through damage with another one of your creatures. You can pay 1 and a white to prevent all combat damage that would be dealt to and dealt by Deathblade Elite this turn. Let's have a look at our other creatures. Most of them have evasion, which really helps push through boards that have Augur of Bolas's and Seagate Oracles stuck to them. First, we have Core Skyfisher, which costs 1 and a white for a 2/3 flying, and when it enters the battlefield, you return a permanent you control to its owner's hand. Core Skyfisher synergizes perfectly with Thraben Inspector. Picking it up and replaying it means you get another clue to draw another card. It also synergizes really well with Icacian Javelineers, resetting that javelin counter so that you can kill another creature with it. As you're probably noticing, most of our creatures are soldiers or knights, which means War Falcon actually reads that it can't attack unless you control another creature. War Falcon being able to block regardless of whether you control another creature or not is actually relevant. It has 2 power, so if we're unfortunately on the back foot against a deck with Delvers or Moldrifters and we're at risk to dying to them, we can just stick our War Falcon in the way to trade. Our last evasive threat is Leonin Skyhunter. It costs 2 white mana for a 2/2 flyer. This is just another great evasive attacker to close out the game around our opponent's board. Our last creature isn't evasive, but it's an awesome value play if you can recur it with Core Skyfisher, and otherwise it fogs out your opponent's edicts pretty well. It's Loyal Kathar. Loyal Kathar costs 2 white mana for a 2/2 with Vigilance, and when it dies, you can return it to the battlefield transformed under your control at the beginning of the next end step. When it transforms, it becomes Unhallowed Kathar, a 2/1 zombie soldier that can't block. Like I said before, we're trying to win with creature damage, so we don't run a ton of non-creature spells, but each one that is included is super useful and synergistic to our plan. First, we have Journey to Nowhere. It costs 1 and a white for an enchantment, and when it enters the battlefield, you exile target creature. When Journey to Nowhere leaves the battlefield, you return the exiled card to the battlefield under its owner's control. While some of our creatures are evasive, most of them are really small, so our opponent is going to have a chance to commit blockers that can get in the way of our attackers as the game goes on. Journey to Nowheres are just a bit of insurance against our opponent surviving by that strategy. We can pick off their early blockers and make sure we can kill them before their board gets too intense that more journeys can't help. We also have Cartouche of Solidarity. It costs 1 white for an aura, and when it enters the battlefield, you create a 1/1 white warrior creature token with Vigilance. Enchanted creature gets +1/+1 and has first strike. Cartouche is absolutely amazing with Deathblade Elite, giving it first strike so that it trades with a lot of the creatures it provokes into blocking it. This also generates a body, which helps our plan of going wide and getting in damage. Our last non-land card is Mutagenic Growth. It costs 1 green Phyrexian mana, which just basically means pay 2 life life to cast it. It's an instant and it gives target creature +2/+2 until end of turn. Mutagenic Growth can help our creatures trade up out of nowhere, and it also serves as a pseudo counter spell for any damage based removal our opponents happen to point at our creatures. Alright, let's have a look at this mana base. It's pretty simple, just 16 planes and 2 Kybera Crossroads. We want so many basic lands because we want to hit our 1 drops first thing. Alright, let's have a look at this sideboard. First, we have a couple of Sun Lances for dealing with more of our opponent's creatures if they skew a little bit more aggressive than we do. We have a couple of Last Breaths for specific threats like Kiln Fiend or Tireless Tribe that might combo off. This will deal with them in a pinch. We have a few Relic of Progenitus for controlling the graveyards of slower decks. We have 2 Prismatic Strands if our opponent is on a combo-based attack strategy. We have 2 Lone Missionaries for buffering our life total against burn. We have 1 Aura Fracture for destroying some enchantments. And we have 3 Standard Bearers for picking up all of our opponent's auras and pump spells. And there you have it, Mono White Aggro featuring Cavalry Drillmaster by Nichols. We're going to take this deck into a league at twitch.tv/anynewprovince this Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Atlantic time. We're there every Tuesday night playing Possibly Pauper Playable decks. Before I go, I just want to remind you that you can like the video or subscribe to the channel down below. I'd seriously appreciate it. It's a great way to let me know you've enjoyed everything, and it really encourages me to keep making great Pauper content. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this deck tech, and hopefully I'll see you on Tuesday night.